Hey guys, what's up? It's Noah and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the backbone to any successful Amazon business, and that is having good product research methods. In this video, I'm going to be going over step by step how I personally do product research for my own business, and that's going to be for both wholesale dropshipping as well as for buying in bulk for wholesale FBA. For this video, I created a presentation to go ahead and display the information, and you can access all of the information in this video in the description down below. The last thing that I'm going to mention is if you haven't already joined the Facebook group, the link for that is also down in the description. So without further ado, sit back, relax, and let's go ahead and get into some product research. My business is mainly using wholesale suppliers that offer dropshipping. This way I can offer all of their catalog without actually buying any inventory. Also, when I notice that an item that I'm dropshipping is selling well, I might contact my supplier and see if I can buy in bulk to go ahead and I can get a discount to increase my margins, and then I might convert that listing to FBA as well. That's why there's such a good dynamic by using wholesale suppliers that dropship, because you have the versatility to either dropship or you can actually go ahead and buy the item in bulk. For this product research method, there's gonna be four main points. The first is that we're going to need to get a price sheet from our supplier. The next is that we're going to be using a scanning software to scan that sheet. After that, we're going to be using Keepa, which is a very in-depth and powerful tool that we're going to be using to do further analysis on these listings. And last but not least, we're going to be using a calculator to go ahead and determine our exact profit, as well as we're also going to be using Jungle Scout to just see the sales velocity and to know how many units are selling each day, and maybe to even determine right away if the item is worth more valuable or we're going to make more profit by going straight to FBA rather than just drop shipping it. The first step is to get a product data sheet from our supplier, also known as a price sheet. So what you're going to do is you're going to ask your supplier for a price sheet or a product data sheet. Typically, you can either just ask them, you can call them up, or you can email them, and they'll be able to send you one directly. Or if you're working with a larger wholesaler or a larger distributor, you can go directly to their website and you can download it there. The two most important things that we want to see on the price sheet are that the items have product identifiers. This is either going to be a UPC code, an ASIN, or an EAN. This way, when we scan the sheet, that it's going to be able to find those listings on Amazon. And we also want the sheet to have the cost. This way we can know if we're actually going to be profitable for this item. Having a price sheet will allow us to quickly go ahead and see what items our supplier has, what cost we can actually get the items for, and then we can take that sheet, upload it to a scanning software, and quickly find out what the price is on Amazon and see if we're going to be profitable. So let's talk about how to get a price sheet from your supplier. The two most common ways are that you're either just going to download it directly from their website, or you're going to call them or email them, and they're either going to send you a direct link to download it, or they're going to send you the file directly in the email. So for CTW, as well as a lot of other wholesalers, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to go to your account and then you might find the file there. So for CTW, you would click on your account, then you would click on My Dashboard, and then you would see something that says Product File. From there, you're gonna click on that and it's gonna bring you up to the Product Price Report. And you'll see here, you can actually download a full file of all of the items, and you're gonna be able to get in the file the name, the inventory, the measurements, as well as the UPC code. Now, on some suppliers, you might actually be able to customize the different columns that you can download with the sheet. So for here, you can see that you can actually add a column for a picture, a SKU, the weight, and also the price of the item, which is something that we need on the file. And from there, you would just click here and you would click download. And then you're going to be downloading the CSV, which is going to be the full product data sheet for this supplier. So now let's talk about an example with a supplier that does not have you download it directly from their website. So I contacted the supplier, Game World Distributors, and I called them and I emailed them asking if I can get a price list or a product data sheet. And I was emailed this price list, which had all of their items. So here you'll see that we have the UPC code, we have the title of the item, we also have the quantity that they have on hand, and we also have the sales price. So if we ordered a specific amount, it was about $1,500, then we would be able to get every unit at this price. So now that we've talked about how you can get a price sheet from a supplier, the next step is we're going to be taking that price sheet and we're going to be uploading it to our scanning software. The scanning software that I personally use in my business is Scan Unlimited. It is the scanning software that I recommend. There are a bunch of others out there like analyzer.tool. You can also use Source Mogul. You can use the Bocrable analyzer tool. For me and my business, I've just used Scan Unlimited. It's very good, and I can also talk directly to the CEO and I can ask them for certain features to be added. So after you've gotten your product data sheet, what you're then going to do in Scan Unlimited or whatever scanning software you're using is you're going to run a new scan and you're then going to upload that file. By uploading that file, it's going to then scan that file for scan unlimited, depending on the file size. If you have about 10,000 items, it might take a few minutes. From there, it's going to scan the entire sheet, locate all of those listings on Amazon, and it's going to give you all of the data for those listings. So for example, I just downloaded the price sheet from CTW. So after you download your price sheet from your supplier, you would go ahead and you would run a new scan. And after the scan is complete, what I like to do is I like to set the items per page to 100. This way I can see a lot more items. Then from there, we are going to be applying filters. So this way we can better go ahead and filter through all the items so we can see which ones are profitable. Now, Scan Unlimited shows you a lot of different data. You'll see that from the sheet that I downloaded from CTW, we have the UPC, we have the cost. Now, what you can actually do on Scan Unlimited is you can actually apply a discount or a premium. So let's say your supplier offers you a 10% discount. What you could do right here is in scan settings, you can actually apply your discount. So let's say my supplier was offering me a 10% discount. I can put that right there, and then it would put it for this error for every item that I would get a 10% discount off of the cost. Some other crucial information that you'll see is that you can quickly see the Keepa chart. So right here, it loads the Keepa chart. Also, you can go ahead and see a picture of the item, as well as you can click right here and it would actually take you to the listing on Amazon. So some other useful information is that Scan Unlimited compiles all the data from all of its users, and it's going to go ahead and show you brands, or it's going to show you companies that have a history of filing IP complaints. So you would actually see right here, if you saw a red mark or you saw like an X, that would mean that that brand actually has a history of filing IP complaints. But scrolling over further to the side, you'll see that we actually have the more crucial information, which is what is the net profit for this item based off of the cost that we had on our sheet and the price that it's selling for on Amazon, as well as our fees, and what is the ROI that we will be making. So with the sheet, we can actually filter through it, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to hide all the useless information. So we don't really need the title, we don't need the package height, we don't need the length, we don't need the width, we don't need the weight, we don't need the quantity. And you can also go ahead and you can put a lot of this information, you can hide it. So once that information is hidden, we now have a much more concise sheet, and it's going to be easier to work with. After we go ahead and now that we have all the columns that we want, we're now going to filter to have all of the listings that we want, or that the listings are going to match all of the criteria that we're looking for. The very first thing that I go ahead and do is what I do is I sort by the sales rank. So I apply my filters. So let's say I wanted the sales rank that was less than 1 million. By having a sales rank that's less than 1 million, that's going to actually guarantee that the item has sold within the last year or the last 2 years. And remember, we're drop shipping, so we're not ordering any inventory, so we don't have to worry about buying dead inventory or buying a product that won't sell. So we can do less than or equal to, and we can actually do 1.5 million. This way, because we're drop shipping, like I said, we don't have to worry about inventory. So we're going to add that. And then what else I like to do is I like to do greater than or equal to one, because sometimes you'll find that the sales rank gets messed up and sometimes it will say negative one. So just to filter those out, I like to put greater than or equal to one. After that, you can hit apply filters, and it's going to find all the items that match that criteria for the sales rank. So after you set the filters for the sales rank, the next thing that I set are the filters for the offers. So I like to see a listing where it has less than or equal to 5 sellers. Some people will go ahead and they'll overshoot that and they'll put 8. Typically, I just like to see at maximum 5 sellers on the listing. So I'm going to add that. And the next filter that I set is for the net profit. Now, this is going to be depending on the business model that you want to run. If you want to sell items where you're making $2 profit, then you're going to have to sell a lot more units in order to get more profit. So what I like to do is I like to set it to where I'm equal or I'm making more than $5. So you'll see right here, I set it to greater than or equal to $5. And the next thing is I set the ROI. So for drop shipping, the margins are usually smaller. I like to see margins between 25 to 30 to 45%, somewhere between there. Especially if I'm doing wholesale, I like to see margins of 40% or higher. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually set it to greater than or equal to, and I'm going to put 25% as the minimum. And then from there, I can do further analysis and I can talk to the supplier to see if I can get discounts for the items. So once all of my filters are here, I'm going to hit apply filters, and it's going to apply all the filters and show me all of the results. So after you apply all of your filters and you found the listings that meet your criteria, the next step, what I do is I go ahead and I download. So you can go ahead and download filtered. And once I download filtered, I now have all of the listings that meet my criteria. And these are most likely listings that I can dropship. However, if I wanted to do wholesale, I would then do further analysis to see if it actually is worth it to go ahead and buy these listings in bulk. So the way that you can do further analysis inside of Scan Unlimited is, first off, you can go ahead and you can apply more strict filters. And by applying more strict filters, you can go ahead and you can find items that are going to meet more strict criteria. What else you can do is you can also click right here and it's going to pull up the sales chart from Keepa. And you'll notice right here that you can go ahead and see the sales rank history as well as the price history. And you can also see if Amazon has ever sold on that listing, which is very valuable information. The other thing that you can do is you can click right here and it's actually going to provide you with a lot more product data. So the information that Scan Unlimited offers you is, first off, it shows you the buy box price. It shows you the change from when that price changed. It shows you the condition for the buy box, as well as it also shows you the sales rank, and it shows you over the average of a 30-day average, a 90-day average, and a 180-day average. Also, it shows you the price and rank history from the Keepa chart, and you can sort that by the length of time, so 30 days, 90 days, or 365 days. You can also go ahead and see all the offers on a listing. And this is all crucial information because we can make informed decisions based off of the info that we're given. For example, we can go ahead and we can go back to our price sheet and we can see how much the item is going to cost us. And then we can go and scroll down and you'll see that they actually have a profit and ROI calculator. So you'll see right now that the calculator is on FBA, but let's say that we switched it to MFN. Now this is going to be for fulfillment by merchant. So what we're going to do is we have the product cost. Let's say our shipping cost for this item was $10. And then we see that the prep fee is going. So let's say we can put the prep fee at $2 is going to be our drop ship cost. And then you'll see right here that the product cost is 10. We do not get a discount. So you'll see that we still do make a net profit of $6, which is going to be an ROI of 60% on our product cost of $10. So there is a lot of information and a lot of product research that you can do within Scan Unlimited. However, there are a few more steps that I go to before I actually decide whether or not a product is worth buying in bulk. So from here, I could just enter in all of my information for my manufacturer fulfilled or for fulfilled by merchant. And by entering in all the information like the shipping cost and the prep fee and whether or not I get a discount, I'm able to see if I will be profitable for this item. So I can know right here if this item is actually going to be profitable for dropshipping. So just based off of this information alone, versus also how many sellers are on the listing, I can determine that this is going to be a good listing for dropshipping. So what I would do is I would just hop on this listing, and that's as simple as that. However, now I want to actually do a little bit more in-depth analysis, and I want to do further research to see if this listing will be a good listing for FBA. So the next tool that we're going to be talking about is going to be Keepa. This is going to allow us to do a lot more in-depth analysis, and we're going to be able to see under the hood, so to speak, and we're going to be able to see all of the history and all the information for any listing. Keepa allows you to do in-depth analysis, and I've talked to sellers that do $1 million a year, and also you can go ahead and watch videos from Watch Me Amazon on YouTube or any seller that does $20 million a year on Amazon, and all of them recommend using Keepa. That's how powerful of a tool this is. The other tool that I use is I use Jungle Scout. Jungle Scout lets me go ahead and it lets me see the estimated monthly sales, so I know how many units are selling and if it's worth it to go ahead and buy in bulk and how many units I should actually buy. So going back to our scan, let's say that we want to determine if this item was actually worth going further in-depth analysis on, and we wanted to see if this was worth buying in bulk. So what you can do from Scan Limited is you can just click on the item title, and that's going to bring you up to the item page on Amazon. So once you open up the product detail page on Amazon, you're going to scroll down, and you'll see this is where the Keepa data populates. Now Keepa is a very, very in-depth tool. And if you're just seeing this for the first time, this looks like too much information, and this is going to give you information overload. So the first thing to note is that you can actually break down the Keepa chart into three main graphs. The first one is going to show you the price history. It's also going to show you the buy box, as well as it's going to show you if Amazon is selling on a listing. The next one, which is right here, the second graph, is going to show you the sales rank history. And then the third one is going to show you the reviews. It's also going to show you how many sellers have sold on that listing throughout the time period that you are looking at. So this is not going to be too in-depth of an analysis of Keepa because honestly, there's just so much information that you can go over. But what you want to do is you want to actually just toggle between all of the information that you can see. So you'll see right here by clicking on this, it actually turns off all of the data. And to turn it back on, I can just click on it again. And now I can actually see all the data. So let's say I wanted to just isolate one point and I wanted to see the buy box. Now I can see what the buy box has been for the past, and you can actually determine it by the different date ranges. So let's say I wanted to determine it for the past year. Now it shows me the history for the buy box. So I see that before in January, it was at around $19.31. And now today, right now, the buy box is actually at around $32.99. So this gives you all of the data and you can actually sort it by different date ranges. And you can even go back to when the listing was created about a year ago, or actually about 1,000 days ago. And then from there, we can actually put new information. So let's say we want to see what the new price is selling at, and let's go to the 3-month period. So we see that the new price right here was actually selling for $26.50, but the buy box was still $32.99. So we see that there is a discrepancy between the buy box and between the new price. And then you can even introduce new information. So let's say we wanted to see the sales rank. So we see that the sales rank is going down, which means that more people are buying it. And we see recently the sales rank has gone all the way up, which means that less people are buying it. So you're able to see a lot of information with Keepa, and you can go ahead and you can even see what the item is selling for on eBay. So we see that on eBay, it's selling for $37.44. You can even see different conditions like new and used and very good. And then you can also go ahead and you can see new third-party FBM. So we can see what the drop shipping prices are for this item, and you can see new third-party for FBA. So we can see what other people who are on the listing for FBA are selling for. So by toggling all this information, you're able to put more information onto your graph to get more data. So one of the best features about Keepa is that it actually shows you if Amazon has been on a listing and for what period they've been on it. So let's say I actually wanted to take a look at this G-Shock watch. I'll see that Amazon has been on the listing and the Amazon price has been $45.89, and the buy box price is also the same price as Amazon. So usually there's no way that you can win the buy box over Amazon. So this is just really good information that I can see, and it might be a reason that I will pass on a listing. So going back to our example of this item, the next box that we could take a look at is the sales rank history. And it's going to show you the overall category, as well as it's also going to show you the sales rank for the subcategory, which we can see as home and kitchen for the overall category. And then the subcategory is artificial flowers. So we see right here that the item was doing well. So when the sales rank goes lower, that means that the item is selling more. When the sales rank goes higher, that means that the item is selling less. So we see right here that the item was getting a lot of sales, it was going down, and it was staying relatively consistent. And then overall, it started to go up, which means that it actually started to sell less. And then the last graph that we can actually open up by clicking more historical data, and we can see the seller history. So we can see that the review count is going up and the rating has been staying at around 4.7, which means that this item is getting really good reviews. So it's a good item. And we see that the new offer count was around 9 to about 7. So it was between 7 and 9 about 3 months ago. And then it started falling off. So then it went to 4, then it went to 3, then it went to 5, and then it went down to 4. So we can see that there used to be a lot of sellers. If we go back to a year, you'll see that at one point there was 23 offers on this listing, and now there are only about 3 to 5. So that might be something that we want to take a look into. We might want to see if it's in stock on the supplier's website. We might want to see that if maybe the supplier doesn't sell it anymore, maybe one of our competitors just bought all of the stock and then they shipped it all into FBA. So using Keepa is going to allow you to see a lot of data. And typically, if I see Amazon is on the listing, then I won't even consider doing it for FBA. But just using all of this data is going to allow me to make an informed decision about whether or not I want to continue and proceed with buying in bulk. So some other cool features about Keepa is if you hover over the statistic, then you'll see that you can just quickly see all the information. You can see what Amazon is selling it for. You can see the new price, the used price, the sales rank, and then you can also see the average. As well as if you click on the data tab, it's going to show you all of the data for the listing, the reviews, the review count, the last price change. So you get to see all of this information right here. It also shows you the eBay price, the new average price for the 90 days. So just a lot of information. And this tool only cost about $17. So I think it's very worth it. And I think it's a must-have tool, especially if you're going to be selling on Amazon. So going back to doing product research, now that we saw that this item, that we see that the price is increasing, we see that the sales rank is actually increasing, which means less people are buying it, as well as we see that the offers has relatively been dropping. So this might mean that we need to do a lot of further in-depth analysis into this listing. So what we can do is we can actually go back to our supplier's website and we can take a further look at it, as well as we can go to Scan Limited. And again, we can just cross out that item for buying in bulk, but maybe it would be worth it for dropshipping. So then we can go to the next item and we can just do more in-depth analysis. And again, I would just look at the Keepa chart, check if Amazon is there. I would check if the sellers have remained consistent. Let's say you see 19 or you see 20 and then all of a sudden it drops off to 3. That's an indication that maybe something happened. You can also take a look at the review count. You want to see, make sure that the reviews are actually good and that they're decent. If a product has 1-star reviews, then you're going to get a lot of returns. So there's just a lot of information to consider when you're choosing a product that you want to sell, both for dropshipping as well as for wholesale. So the last piece of information that I just want to show is that you can actually go ahead and you can load up the offers on Keepa and it'll show you the price graph for the sellers. So we see that this seller has been on this listing and they've been on it for around 8 months right now. And you can see that they've increased their price over time. And you can also see that this one right here, they've actually kept their price relatively flat and then they increased it and then they decreased it again. So you're able to see a lot of information. You can see their review count. You can see their rating. So this is actually Amazon Warehouse, so that was a bad example. But here you can see this one, 92% rating. They're doing FBA and their Prime. And you can see right here that they have kept their price relatively flat, then they increased it, and then they decreased it. So you're able to keep track of all of your competitors. So let's say that we have actually indicated that this is going to be a good listing. The next and the last step is I use Jungle Scout and I also use my FBA calculator. So I use the FBA calculator. So it's called the Amazon FBA calculator. You can find it on the Google Chrome store. And from here, it just quickly pops up. I can enter in my product cost, which was $10. And then my ship to Amazon fee, let's say it's $2 per unit. So based off of these current prices, FBA, I would make 26%. And also the estimated sales are 13 to 14 sales a day. So we're gonna run Jungle Scout and we're just going to see what Jungle Scout says. So Jungle Scout says that this listing is getting about 1,000 sales a month and that the daily sales are about 19 and that you'll see that the estimated monthly revenue is about 36,000. So also on Jungle Scout, you can go ahead and you can see the price changes. But again, we just saw all of this on Keepa, but it's just another feature, as well as you can also go ahead and you can see the sales rank history. So based off of all of this data, what I have determined is that this listing would actually be a good fit for doing FBA. There's good margins, as well as there's not too much competition. However, we would just need to do some more in-depth analysis, make sure that we can get it from our supplier, see if our supplier can ship directly to Amazon, and just a bunch of other things like that. So going back to Scan Unlimited, what I would do is I would just download the file. And most of these items are probably going to be good items for drop shipping, depending on how much your shipping cost is and depending if you can get a discount and depending on several other factors. But based off of all this data, all these 110 items would probably be good for drop shipping. So you can either upload this in bulk to your software and then your software can upload those onto Amazon. Or you can also do further in-depth analysis on all these 100 listings, or you can even apply more stricter filters. Let's say you only wanted ROI of 40% or more, then you can go ahead and do more in-depth analysis to determine if a listing would be a good fit for FBA. So that's gonna be it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. This has been an insight into my product research strategy for both dropshipping as well as for doing wholesale FBA. So for all the tools in the video, I actually am an affiliate for, and you can find my affiliate codes down below. I do get a small kickback, but it's at no cost to you. And you can also get a discount to all of the tools by using my codes. So thank you guys for watching. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I wanna start doing longer in-depth tutorials. I think that's a really good way to do YouTube videos and a really good way to teach you guys. So also you'll see that it says right here, questions. You can also leave a comment below. So the last point is if you guys have any questions, just leave a comment below. I answer all comments and I answer all questions and I will do my best to answer the best that I can to any questions that you might have. So thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a thumbs up. Stay tuned for the next video. Peace.